Alright guys, this is Chris G. I'm back with my gaming channel, T.Gameology. And I'm here doing Bioshock. This will be walkthrough 10. And also the beginning of chapter 10. Alright guys, so let's get out there and do this. Thank you guys for the love and the support. Subscribing to my channel. Liking my videos, commenting good or bad. I appreciate it all, guys. Thank you very much. And with that being said, let's go out there and kick some butt.
Watch yourself, Ryan Stora. We best keep it working. It's time to eat or go home empty.
Oh, Thank you. Okay. You saved me.
Yeah.
Imagine the will it took to create a place like this. What do you think? Not you can do it and break.
Guys, for real.
From the moment you do that Bioshock, you can feel the story grab hold of Upslain's Crashes at Sea, a mysterious lighthouse, a sprawling city beneath the ocean, hooking the player from the first touch without overwhelming him with convoluted RPG mechanics, was key to the success of the game, and the skillful ramping up of Bioshock's legendary gameplay.
Bioshock has an amazing opening sequence.
I can't imagine the game without it. Guys, are we really watching this in the middle of a game?
But I understand that didn't come online until the very end of development.
We had a couple of really depressing playtests.
We had built all these systems. We were doing a good job of giving basically people playground to play with, and when we had a playtest, we realized how bad of a job we were doing exposing the system to the player, because we were so in these systems and in our heads, we had no idea that we were just facing them towards the player at all.
So after that playtest, we took a long cold look at what we were doing and realized that we had to introduce that we were confident enough in the systems that they were going to be fun to play with the player.
But we really had to think about how we're going to introduce these systems to the player in such a way that They understand why the systems were there. You can't ship a reading file if they're going to expect people to read it. It has to be part of the experience. So the challenge is how do you introduce people to these systems, but do it in such a way that it fits within the narrative. We had to integrate all of these things into the story, cleaning it so that the player felt like it was one smooth experience.
We had a bunch of punch that came out of it. It was a lap of the test, and we had a hand. It was one of the most depressing experiences. We basically gave people what essentially became the demo, and people played it, and it was in Boston, and we were sort of behind this glass, and we saw this sort of Boston guy. It was a wicked piece of shit, you know, they hate him, and they're like, fun of it, and they were saying, you know, it's like, watch this, and dies, and dies, and dies, getting each other up, and the stupidest thing they've ever seen.
And I remember the focus of this guy was like a doctor giving you the bad news. Sorry, Ken. I think we started talking. As we talk, we started thinking about what are the same things. What do we feel? What is it? We think there's something there.
Well, how did we miss it? And we decided that they didn't understand who their role in the world was. Because the game at that point started with you in the ocean after the plane crash. And the fraction of fiction, you see, my parents said that I was going to be great things, or whatever that is. The plane is a critical establishment, your cigarette is very 60s looking, all that stuff was established. So we decided, no time, no money, so we came up with a script. A line, a line, a line, a line, a name, our artists recorded the line. Steven and Sean, and that's back to work on building this very simple sequence, relatively simple plane crash actually happens over the Bioshock logo, but I saw a radio playing behind that, the altitude, the crash. That set the emotion, the screaming terror of the plane crash, and all of a sudden, the next real encounter we have is people playing the demo of the encounter, and all of a sudden, I remember back in the day, we talked about it, and I remember that night, people on the forum going nuts, even though the game had a lot of press attention.
When people finally played it, you go through that sequence, you got some of those mass excitement around the game ship, they're like,
It was basically like now, a few weeks after that, we were a month before the game came out, like the plane was supposed to go. We felt like we were so close to having something good.
That we just rolled the dice on it, and we worked really hard on it.
I remember how much time I spent on just that recording altitude. After that, still here, the different version of that in my head. So much time that these guys were working on getting the animations right.
The scene was shot in engine, but we decided to render it so that we had to do less QA on it. It wasn't going to be some weird streaming error or crash error. It was just like we just wanted to show the video.
And it's interesting because once you start in the ocean, we have this experience of testing a lot. But the water effects, how beautiful the water effects were. People didn't realize we were out of it. So they would just sit there and stare. And they took over the controller. As the engine was playing through the game, we were testing, and I'm sure there was a debate about when would be the ramp.
Did that change at all towards the end of development, or like, oh, we're going to get people together at this point, or is it we're going to trigger these plasmids? How did that?
So, like, we moved guns around. For instance, there was a big debate about originally you found a gun in the lighthouse. Right there. And it's a shooter, right? Like, what the hell? And we had a lot of debates about it.
Alright guys, I'm going to end this video here. Flip out of here. And when they come back, we'll be in this very room, and I'll have to look up, what am I looking up? Journal, see what components we need for this bomb. Alright guys, so again, appreciate all the love and support, and I'll be back shortly with another video. Alright guys, one love, appreciate all the support, peace out.